Max, what's your reaction to what went down on the field?
Well, obviously there needs to be a suspension because Mason Rudolph needs to be suspended at least a game. Let's start with that. He was the one who started the fight, tried to take Myles Garrett's helmet off. I mean, he tried to got underneath, tried to twist it off. Then Garrett's like, oh, okay, that's what we're doing. Okay, I'm going to take your helmet off. Then as Myles Garrett's being restrained by two of Mason Rudolph's teammates, Mason Rudolph, without his helmet, charges Myles Garrett. So Myles Garrett, as he said, foolishly swung with his helmet. By the way, it's in the rules. You know what happens if you swing with your helmet? Article 17 uses helmet as a weapon. A player may not use a helmet that is no longer worn by anyone as a weapon to strike, swing, or throw at an opponent. So what's the penalty for that, right? It's already in the rules. Illegal use of helmet as a weapon, loss of 15 yards and automatic disqualification. So 15 yards, and Myles Garrett should be disqualified from the game. And I would also say, when you look at swinging at a guy's head with, you know, unprotected head with a helmet, a 2-4 game penalty, I would understand. There has been a totally hysterical reaction to this. And I think part of it's because the culture of, like, let me just take this in, out of, put it into absolute terms, right? In terms of the danger, which has been overstated, what just happened and everything. In baseball, guy throws at another guy 100 miles an hour in the head. You know what? He gets a warning from the ump. In hockey, you swing at a guy's head with a stick. You might get a 25-game suspension. It's possible. In other words, like a quarter of the season, a third of the season, the equivalent of 2, 4, 6 games, something like that in a football suspension. But people talking about Myles Garrett, rest of the season, kick him out of the league, send him to jail. Calm down. In a fight, if one person escalates, and the other person retaliates, even if the retaliation is considered disproportional, we don't just look at the disproportional retaliation. Mason Rudolph was at the end of a game in which he stunk, 4 interceptions. The other team's about to win. The defensive end's on top of him. He's clearly frustrated. He tries to pull the helmet off. He gets retaliated in kind while the other guy's being restrained. He charges them, and he gets swung at. Myles Garrett's right. It's foolish. He shouldn't have swung with the helmet. Everyone calm down. Myles Garrett, 2. You want to argue 4 games? Fine. Mason Rudolph, at least a game. Done.
Your position was asinine from the moment you said Mason Rudolph is the focus because he instigated it. That was asinine in and of itself. To sit up there and talk about on a day like today, this morning, that the first thought that comes to your mind is that the quarterback who is under the 260-pound defensive lineman that just slammed him to the ground because he tried to take off his helmet, I think that's utterly ridiculous. Now, let me get to Myles Garrett. I'm not saying Mason Rudolph doesn't deserve to be suspended because he does. What I'm saying to you is this. Myles Garrett is the focal point here. He deserves to be suspended for the rest of the season. He can't be seen again this season. And I predict he won't be. Knowing Troy Vincent the way that I do, covering him from his days in Philadelphia, knowing how principled of a man that he is and the way he takes things like this in terms of the imagery, the optics, the fact that it was on national television, the fact that you sat up there and it was the quarterback, no less, and you swung the helmet so violently at him the way that you did. And, oh, by the way, you connected, okay, considering what could have happened if that crown or that helmet had connected with Mason Rudolph and what that could have led to, there is no question that he deserves to be suspended for the rest of the season. As a matter of fact, let me be state clearly for the record. I think Myles Garrett will be lucky if he doesn't get suspended for 14 games. I think he'll be lucky if he doesn't get suspended for the final 6 games of this regular season and the first 8 games of the next season. Now, that might be a bit too excessive. I think the 6 games, you know, being done for the rest of this season warrants enough punishment. I'm certainly not advocating that he gets suspended for 14 games, but I'm not going to rule it out. I'm not going to rule it out with Troy Vincent. I'm not going to rule it out with John Runyon. I'm not going to rule it out with Derrick Brooks. Not those guys that I've known for years. I'm not going to rule it out. Anything's possible except the notion that he's going to get off light. Yeah. That ain't possible.
I don't think four games is light.
Well, I'm telling you, it's going to be a minimum of 6. You can book it. He ain't going to be seen again this season.
And you think?
We're talking about what should, not what will. I agree with you. There's a good chance that will happen. I'm talking about what should
happen. Okay, that's fine. I got it. The point that I'm trying to make is this. Let's go back and analyze not just the play but the game. Myles Garrett was beating up Mason Rudolph all night long. The Cleveland Browns was beating them up as well. I mean, one of the hits on the receivers, a headshot, you knocked him out, you concussed him, you get ejected from the game. The Steelers were having injuries. James Conner got injured. Juju Smith-Schuster got injured. Another receiver with the illegal hit to the head got it. They got beat up last night. And then legally, Myles Garrett was beating up Mason Rudolph all night long. It's right. 8 seconds left. It's 8 seconds. You won the game. It's 21-7. You wrap your arms around him after he gets rid of the football, and you drive your body into him and when you're taking him down. That was a penal. He was going to get penalized for that play in and of itself. So when you, after you do that, you're on top of Mason Rudolph, and he reacts, why? Damn, you beat us up enough. You got the game. The game is over, and now you're driving me into the ground, which is where the reaction came from. Not that it was acceptable, but that's where the reaction came from. And if you are Myles Garrett with DeCastro in your face, with Pouncey in the vicinity, you don't have to, even, yeah, you could take off his helmet because you upset at him, but then afterwards with two Steelers offensive linemen shielding him from you and you from him, you still take your helmet and swing and connect at his head. There is no excuse for it whatsoever. He's going to pay a price. There's going to be multiple suspensions because league rules stipulate, just like in the NBA, you can't come off the bench. You can't come off the sidelines in the National Football League. So you're going to get guys that are going to get fined. I believe Pouncey is going to get suspended. Immediately reacted after the game. He didn't even deserve it because he lost it at the time. He saw his quarterback get hit with the helmet. But thinking about it, the rule of the law, the letter of the law, okay, you got to suspend Pouncey for a game, for a couple of games probably. Mason Rudolph was an instigator to some degree. You might have to suspend him a game. We don't know what was said to Myles Garrett. Sure. The NFL is looking into that as well. But Myles Garrett, he will be lucky if he doesn't get 14 games. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.